Yeah, much like it did over the weekend when we had the morning storms and then the rest of the day was pretty good. That's what we're looking at right now. Already some drier air is being drawn into the system right into central Iowa here, but we're still dealing with rain up to the north and then out to the east, with a flash flood watch still in effect across the southern counties until 4 o'clock. Now, amounts were generally over an inch to the south and under an inch for central and northern Iowa for the overnight. We did get those gusty winds coming through, though, causing a little bit of damage, knocking the power out for a time. And you can see the rain still falling over near Sigourney, Ottumwa, back through Centerville, but it is moving out to the northeast. So Pella, you'll have some improving weather over the next 20 minutes or so. Still raining in Mason City and near the Iowa Falls area. Still a few raindrops for you, but this will be lifting in towards southeastern Minnesota over the next half an hour to 45 minutes with some drier weather on the way. But a few more showers are now starting to pop up across Nebraska and even across southern Iowa and northern Missouri. We're noticing a few areas of some more raindrops trying to get started here. So taking into the afternoon by 2 p.m., we'll have a slight chance for widely scattered showers, maybe a pop-up thunder shower. Better chances for any heavy rain will be out to the east of I-35. As we head towards 6 p.m., still dealing with spotty showers, especially for southern and northeast Iowa here, with Fort Dodge down through the metro and out toward Audubon, enjoying mainly a dry afternoon. By 11 p.m., still those showers linger right along the Iowa-Missouri border, and overnight here comes another complex of storms. Repeated overnight rains, just like we've had the past several nights, so tomorrow morning's commute will likely be slow and very wet. The middle part of the day is going to be dry. This will be our time of recovery. Get ready for the potential for severe weather tomorrow afternoon, 4 o'clock. The storms fire up to our southwest, racing here by 6 p.m., and it does not look pretty right through 9, 10 o'clock as that heavy rain shield heads out to the east, and the storms even linger overnight Tuesday night into early on Wednesday. Throughout the rest of today and tonight, right around a quarter to a half inch of rain for central Iowa, another inch off to the south, and watch what happens with those Tuesday evening storms. Wow, that is a lot of rain. 2 to 4 inches or more could be falling, especially across the southeastern half of the state that's already soaked and waterlogged. We do have a slight risk for severe weather today here in central Iowa, and enhanced risk out to the east. They're going to see the roughest weather while our weather tries to settle down for a short time. But tomorrow afternoon, we've got an enhanced risk for severe weather across south central and southwest Iowa, and all modes of severe weather are going to be possible. This afternoon, any thunderstorm could put down heavy rainfall, so be alert for flash flooding rains. Damaging winds, hail still a concern, and into tomorrow afternoon and evening, even the tornado risk starts to get on the increase. Here in Des Moines, we're enjoying a little break from the rain. We've got some blue skies out there, some really pretty clouds too, and it is warm and muggy, 71 here in Des Moines. The dew point has climbed back into the 60s, and the wind is really gusty coming in from the southwest. Off and on chances for storms continue throughout the afternoon, but widely scattered at best. That wind is going to be howling in from the southwest, at times gusting close to 40. Here's your 8-day forecast. Tomorrow is really the day to watch. By the afternoon and the evening, severe risk. We'll be here to monitor the situation for you. The weather finally settles down, though, at the end of the week.